Albanian language, Wikipedia article audio. Latin, Albanian Braille. Albanian, or Gjuhëshqipe, is a language of the Indo-European family, in which it occupies an independent branch. It is an official language in Albania and Kosovo and has official minority status in Macedonia, Italy, Romania, Montenegro, Serbia, and others. The language has an official status in Ulcinje, southern Montenegro. Albanian is also spoken by large Albanian communities in Europe, the Americas, and Australia. Geographic distribution. Europe. The two main dialects of Albanian are Gjeg and Tosk. Gjeg is primarily spoken in the north, while Tosk is spoken in the south. Standard Albanian is based on the Tosk dialect. The number of Albanian speakers in the Balkans is estimated to be approximately 5 million. Centuries-old communities speaking Albanian dialects can be found scattered in Croatia, Greece, Italy, Sicily, and Calabria, as well as in Romania and Ukraine. There is also a large Albanian diaspora. The language is spoken by approximately 7 million people, primarily in Albania, Kosovo, Greece, Italy, Macedonia, and Montenegro. However, due to the large Albanian diaspora, the total number of speakers is much higher than the native speakers in southern Europe. The Albanian language is the official language of Albania and Kosovo. It is spoken by the entire Albanian population in both. Albanian is a recognized minority language in Croatia, Italy, Macedonia, Montenegro, Romania, and in Serbia. Albanian is also spoken in the Thesprotia and Preveza regional units and in a few villages in Ioannina and Florina regional units in Greece. Albanian is the third most spoken language in Italy. This is due to the strong historical ties between the countries. Italy has a historical Albanian minority of about 500,000, which are scattered across southern Italy known as Arborish. Approximately 1 million Albanians from Kosovo are dispersed throughout Germany, Switzerland, and Austria. These are mainly refugees from Kosovo that migrated during the Kosovo War. In Switzerland, the Albanian language is the sixth most spoken language with 176,293 native speakers. Americas. There are large numbers of Albanian speakers in the United States, Argentina, Chile, Uruguay, and Canada. Some of the first ethnic Albanians to arrive in the United States were Arborish. Arborish have a strong sense of identity, and are unique in that they speak an archaic dialect of Tosk Albanian called Arborish. In North America there are approximately 250,000 Albanian speakers. It is spoken in the eastern area of the United States in cities like New York City, New Jersey, Boston, Philadelphia, Ohio, Connecticut, and Detroit. Greater New Orleans has a large Arborish community. Oftentimes, wherever there are Italians, there are a few Arborish mixed with them. Arborish Americans, therefore, are often indistinguishable from Italian Americans due to being assimilated into the Italian American community. Asia and Oceania. In Argentina, there are nearly 40,000 Albanian speakers, mostly in Buenos Aires. Approximately 1.3 million people of Albanian ancestry live in Turkey, and more than 500,000 recognizing their ancestry, language, and culture. There are other estimates, however, that place the number of people in Turkey with Albanian ancestry and/or background upward to 5 million. However, the vast majority of this population is assimilated and no longer possesses fluency in the language, though a vibrant Albanian community maintains its distinct identity in Istanbul to this day. In Egypt there are around 18,000 Albanians, mostly Tosk speakers. Many are descendants of the Janissary of Muhammad Ali Pasha, an Albanian who became Uli, and self-declared Khedive of Egypt and Sudan. In addition to the dynasty that he established, a large part of the former Egyptian and Sudanese aristocracy was of Albanian origin. In addition to the recent emigrants, there are older diasporic communities around the world. Dialects. Albanian is also spoken by Albanian diaspora communities residing in Australia and New Zealand. Orthography. Standard Albanian is based on the Tosk dialect of southern Albania. The Albanian language has two distinct dialects, Tosk, which is spoken in the south, and Geg, spoken in the north. The Shkumbin River is the rough dividing line between the two dialects. Classification. Geg is divided into four sub-dialects: in Northwest Geg, Northeast Geg, Central Geg, and Southern Geg. It is primarily spoken in northern Albania and throughout Montenegro, Kosovo, and northwestern Macedonia. One fairly divergent dialect is the Upper Rika dialect, which is however classified as Central Geg. There is also a diaspora dialect in Croatia, the Arbanesi dialect. Tosk is divided into five sub-dialects, including Northern Tosk, Labarisht, Kam, Arvanitika, and Arbarish. Tosk is spoken in southern Albania, southwestern Macedonia, and northern and southern Greece. Cham Albanian is spoken in northwestern Greece, while Arvanitika is spoken by the Arvanites in southern Greece. In addition, Arbarish is spoken by the Arbarish people, descendants of 15th and 16th century migrants who settled in southeastern Italy, in small communities in the regions of Sicily and Calabria. Old Albanian. The Albanian language has been written using many different alphabets since the earliest records from the 14th century. The history of Albanian language orthography is closely related to the cultural orientation and knowledge of certain foreign languages among Albanian writers. The earliest written Albanian records come from the Geg area in makeshift spellings based on Italian or Greek. Originally, the Tosk dialect was written in the Greek alphabet and the Geg dialect was written in the Latin script. Both dialects had also been written in the Ottoman Turkish version of the Arabic script, Cyrillic, and some local alphabets. More specifically, the writers from northern Albania and under the influence of the Catholic Church used Latin letters, those in southern Albania and under the influence of the Greek Orthodox Church used Greek letters, while others throughout Albania and under the influence of Islam used Arabic letters. There were initial attempts to create an original Albanian alphabet during the 1750-1850 period. These attempts intensified after the League of Prizren and culminated with the Congress of Monastir held by Albanian intellectuals from 14 to November 22, 1908, in Monastir, which decided on which alphabet to use, and what the standardized spelling would be for standard Albanian. This is how the literary language remains. The alphabet is the Latin alphabet with the addition of the letters, and 10 digraphs, DH, TH, XH, GJ, New Jersey, NG, LL, RR, ZH, and SH. According to Robert Elsie, the 100 years between 1750 and 1850 were an age of astounding orthographic diversity in Albania. In this period, the Albanian language was put to writing in at least 10 different alphabets, most certainly a record for European languages. The diverse forms in which this old Balkan language was recorded, from the earliest documents to the beginning of the 20th century, consist of adaptations of the Latin, Greek, Arabic, and Cyrillic alphabets and a number of locally invented writing systems. Most of the latter alphabets have now been forgotten and are unknown, even to the Albanians themselves. The Albanian language occupies an independent branch of the Indo-European language tree. In 1854, Albanian was demonstrated to be an Indo-European language by the philologist Franz Bopp. Albanian was formerly compared by a few Indo-European linguists with Germanic and Balto-Slavic, all of which share a number of isoglosses with Albanian. Other linguists linked the Albanian language with Latin, Greek and Armenian, while placing Germanic and Balto-Slavic in another branch of Indo-European. According to the central hypothesis of a project undertaken by the Austrian Science Fund, Old Albanian had a significant influence on the development of many languages in the Balkans. This little-known language is being researched using all available texts before a comparison with other Balkan languages is carried out. The outcome of this work will include the compilation of a lexicon providing an overview of all Old Albanian verbs. As project leader Dr. Schumacher explains, the research is already bearing fruit. History. So far, our work has shown that Old Albanian contained numerous modal levels that allowed the speaker to express a particular stance to what was being said. Compared to the existing knowledge and literature, these modal levels are actually more extensive and more nuanced than previously thought. We have also discovered a great many verbal forms that are now obsolete or have been lost through restructuring until now. These forms have barely even been recognized or, at best, have been classified incorrectly. Linguistic affinities. These verbal forms are crucial to explaining the linguistic history of Albanian and its internal usage. However, they can also shed light on the reciprocal relationship between Albanian and its neighboring languages. The researchers are following various leads which suggest that Albanian played a key role in the Balkan Sprachbund. For example, it is likely that Albanian is the source of the suffixed definite article in Romanian, Bulgarian and Macedonian, as this has been a feature of Albanian since ancient times. Domestication of the horse, Kurgan, Kurgan culture, steppe cultures, Bugdnjester, Srednji Stog, Dnjeprdonets, Samara, Kvalinsk, Yamna, Mikhailovka culture. Pontic steppe. Caucasus. Mako. East Asia. Early linguistic influences. Latin influence. Historical presence and location. Proto-IE features. Eastern Europe. Afanasyevo. Northern Europe. Pontic steppe. Northern/Eastern steppe. Usadovo, Cernavod, Kyukyutani. Europe. South Asia. Steppe. Albanian Pi phonological correspondences. Europe. Caucasus. India. Standard Albanian. Elbasan-based standard. Tosk standard. Indo-Aryans. Iranians. Europe. East Asia. Europe. Calls for reform. Indo-Aryan. Iranian. Indian. Iranian. Others. Europe. The first written mention of the Albanian language was on July 14, 1284 in Dubrovnik in modern Croatia when a crime witness named Matthew testified, "I heard a voice shouting on the mountainside in the Albanian language." The first audio recording of Albanian was made by Norbert Jokl on April 4, 1914 in Vienna. During the five-century period of the Ottoman presence in Albania, the language was not officially recognized until 1909, when the Congress of Dibra decided that Albanian schools would finally be allowed. Albanian is considered an isolate within the Indo-European language family. No other language has been conclusively linked to its branch. The only other languages that are the sole surviving member of a branch of Indo-European are Armenian and Greek. The Albanian language is part of the Indo-European language group and is considered to have evolved from one of the Paleo-Balkan languages of antiquity, although it is still uncertain which particular Paleo-Balkan language represents the ancestor of Albanian, or where in southern Europe that population lived. In general, there is insufficient evidence to connect Albanian with one of those languages, whether one of the Illyrian languages, or Thracian and Dacian. Among these possibilities, Illyrian is typically held to be the most probable, though insufficient evidence still clouds the discussion. Although Albanian shares lexical isoglosses with Greek, Germanic, and to a lesser extent Balto-Slavic, the vocabulary of Albanian is quite distinct. In 1995, Taylor, Ring and Warnaugh, using quantitative linguistic techniques, found that Albanian appears to comprise a subgroup with Germanic. However, they argued that this fact is hardly significant, as Albanian has lost much of its original vocabulary and morphology, and so this apparently close connection to Germanic rests on only a couple of lexical cognates, hardly any evidence at all. Education. Phonology. The earliest loanwords attested in Albanian come from Doric Greek, whereas the strongest influence came from Latin. According to Matthew C. Curtis, the loanwords do not necessarily indicate the geographical location of the ancestor of Albanian language. However, according to other linguists, the borrowed words can help to get an idea about the place of origin and the evolution of the Albanian language. According to another group of linguists, Albanian originates from an area located east of its present geographic spread due to the several common lexical items found between the Albanian and Romanian languages. The period during which Proto-Albanian and Latin interacted was protracted, lasting from the 2nd century BC to the 5th century AD. Over this period, the lexical borrowings can be roughly divided into three layers, the second of which is the largest. The first and smallest occurred at a time of less significant interaction. The final period, probably preceding the Slavic or Germanic invasions, also has a notably smaller number of borrowings. Each layer is characterized by a different treatment of most vowels. The first layer follows the evolution of early Proto-Albanian into Albanian, while later layers reflect vowel changes endemic to late Latin. Other formative changes include the syncretism of several noun case endings, especially in the plural, as well as a large-scale palatalization. Consonants. A brief period followed, between the 7th and the 9th centuries, that was marked by heavy borrowings from Southern Slavic, some of which predate the OA shift common to the modern forms of this language group. Starting in the latter 9th century, there was a period characterized by protracted contact with the Proto-Romanians, or Vlachs, though lexical borrowing seems to have been mostly one-sided, from Albanian into Romanian. Such borrowing indicates that the Romanians migrated from an area where the majority was Slavic to an area with a majority of Albanian speakers. Their movement is presumably related to the expansion of the Bulgarian Empire into Albania around that time. Vowels. Schwa. Grammar. Word order. Numerals. Literary tradition. Earliest undisputed texts. Disputed earlier text. Ottoman period. Vocabulary. Cognates with Illyrian. Loan words. Early Greek loans. Gothic loans. Jernej Kopitar was the first to note Latin's influence on Albanian and claimed the Latin loanwords in the Albanian language had the pronunciation of the time of Emperor Augustus. Kopitar gave examples such as Albanian kikar chikpi from Latin sisir, kaitet city, town from civitas, peshk fish from piscus, and shijit arrow from sagitta. The hard pronunciations of Latin C and G are retained as palatal and velar stops in the Albanian loan words. Gustav Meyer and Wilhelm Meyer Lubke later corroborated this. Meyer noted the similarity between the Albanian verbs shkipaqe to speak clearly, enunciate, and shkiptaqe to pronounce, articulate, and the Latin word excipio. Therefore, he believed that the word shkiptar Albanian person was derived from shkipaqe, which in turn was derived from the Latin word excipera. Johann Georg von Hahn, an Austrian linguist, had proposed the same hypothesis in 1854. Ekrem Kabej also noticed, among other things, the archaic Latin elements in Albanian. Harolambi Mihasko demonstrated that. Other authors have detected Latin loanwords in Albanian with an ancient sound pattern from the 1st century BC, for example, Albanian kinjal saddle girth, dwarf elder from Latin singula and Albanian e vegetar old, aged, former from Latin vetris. The Romance languages inherited these words from Vulgar Latin, singula became Romanian cinga girdle, saddle girth, and Vulgar Latin veternus became Romanian btra with circumflex and old. Albanian, Basque, and the surviving Celtic languages such as Breton and Welsh, are the non-Romance languages today that have this sort of extensive Latin element dating from ancient Roman times, which have undergone the sound changes associated with the languages. Other languages in or near the former Roman area either came on the scene later or borrowed little from Latin despite coexisting with it, although German does have a few such ancient Latin loan words. Romanian scholars such as Vatăsescu and Maiescu, using lexical analysis of the Albanian language, have concluded that Albanian was heavily influenced by an extinct Romance language that was distinct from both Romanian and Dalmatian. Because the Latin words common to only Romanian and Albanian are significantly less than those that are common to only Albanian and Western Romance, Maiescu argues that the Albanian language evolved in a region with much greater contact to Western Romance regions than to Romanian-speaking regions, and located this region in present-day Albania, Kosovo, and Western Macedonia, spanning east to Bitolia and Pristina. The place and the time where the Albanian language was formed is uncertain. American linguist Eric Hamp stated that during an unknown chronological period a pre-Albanian population inhabited areas stretching from Poland to the southwestern Balkans. Further analysis has suggested that it was in a mountainous region rather than on a plain or sea coast, while the words for plants and animals characteristic of mountainous regions are entirely original, the names for fish and for agricultural activities are borrowed from other languages. A deeper analysis of the vocabulary, however, shows that this could be a consequence of a prolonged Latin domination of the coastal and plain areas of the country, rather than evidence of the original environment where the Albanian language was formed. For example, the word for fish is borrowed from Latin, but not the word for gills, which is native. Indigenous are also the words for ship, raft, navigation, sea shelves and a few names of fish kinds, but not the words for sail, row, and harbor objects pertaining to navigation itself and a large part of sea fauna. This rather shows that Proto-Albanians were pushed away from coastal areas in early times, thus losing large parts of sea environment lexicon. A similar phenomenon could be observed with agricultural terms. While the words for arable land, corn, wheat, cereals, vineyard, yoke, harvesting, cattle breeding, etc. are native, the words for plowing, farm and farmer, agricultural practices, and some harvesting tools are foreign. This, again, points to intense contact with other languages and people, rather than providing evidence of a possible Urimat. The center of Albanian settlement remained the Mat River. In 1079, they were recorded farther south in the valley of the Shkumbin River. The Shkumbin, a seasonal stream that lies near the old Via Egnatia, is approximately the boundary of the primary dialect division for Albanian, Tosk, and Geg. The characteristics of Tosk and Geg in the treatment of the native and loanwords from other languages are evidence that the dialectal split preceded the Slavic migration to the Balkans, which means that in that period, Albanians were occupying nearly the same area around the Shkumbin River, which straddled the Gjirok line. To the existence of Albanian as a distinct language survive from the 14th century, but they failed to cite specific words. The oldest surviving documents written in Albanian are the Formula e page Zemit, Unti e Pagesant Primenit Tiatit e Tibirit e Tispertit Sinit. Recorded by Palangeli, Bishop of Duras in 1462 in the Geg dialect, and some New Testament verses from that period. The oldest known Albanian printed book, Meshri, or Missal, was written in 1555 by Gjon Buzuku, a Roman Catholic cleric. In 1635 Frang Bardi wrote the first Latin Albanian dictionary. The first Albanian school is believed to have been opened by Franciscans in 1638 in Ptane. One of the earliest dictionaries of Albanian language was written in 1693, which was an Italian language manuscript authored by Montenegrin Sea Captain Julije Bilović Prati Cheshri Vanishi, and includes a multilingual dictionary of hundreds of the most often used words in everyday life in the Italian, Slavo-Illyrico, Greek, Albanian and Turkish languages. Although Albanian has been referred to as the word sister for several words that do not correspond to IE cognates, it has retained many proto-IE features. For example, the demonstrative pronoun **ko is ancestral to Albanian ky/kjo and English he, but not to English this or to Russian e tot. Albanian is compared to other Indo-European languages below, but note that Albanian has exhibited some notable instances of semantic drift. Phonologically, Albanian is not so conservative. Like many IE stocks, it has merged the two series of voiced stops. In addition, voiced stops tend to disappear in between vowels. There is almost complete loss of final syllables and very widespread loss of other unstressed syllables. Pi asterisk O appears as A, while asterisk and asterisk A with macron become O, and pi asterisk appears as E. The palatals, velars, and labiovelars all remain distinct before front vowels, a conservation found otherwise in Levian and related Anatolian languages. Thus pi asterisk k, asterisk k, and asterisk k become th, q, and s, respectively. Another remarkable retention is the preservation of initial asterisk h4 as alb-h. Since World War II, standard Albanian used in Albania has been based on the Tosk dialect. Kosovo and other areas where Albanian is official adopted the Tosk standard in 1969. Until the early 20th century, Albanian writing developed in three main literary traditions, Gag, Tosk, and Arbërish. Throughout this time, an intermediate sub-dialect spoken around Elbasan served as lingua franca among the Albanians, but was less prevalent in writing. The Congress of Monastir of Albanian Writers held in 1908 recommended the use of the Elbasan sub-dialect for literary purposes and as a basis of a unified national language. While technically classified as a southern Gag variety, the Elbasan speech is closer to Tosk in phonology and practically a hybrid between other Gag sub-dialects and literary Tosk. Between 1916 and 1918, the Albanian Literary Commission met in Shkodër under the leadership of Luig J. Gurakuki with the purpose of establishing a unified orthography for the language. The commission, made up of representatives from the north and south of Albania, reaffirmed the Elbasan sub-dialect as the basis of a national tongue. The rules published in 1917 defined spelling for the Elbasan variety for official purposes. The commission did not, however, discourage publications in one of the dialects, but rather laid a foundation for Gag and Tosk to gradually converge into one. When the Congress of Lushnje met in the aftermath of World War I to form a new Albanian government, the 1917 decisions of the Literary Commission were upheld. The Elbasan sub-dialect remained in use for administrative purposes and many new writers embraced for creative writing. Gag and Tosk continued to develop freely and interaction between the two dialects increased. At the end of World War II, however, the new communist regime radically imposed the use of the Tosk dialect in all facets of life, administration, education, and literature. Most communist leaders were Tosks from the south. Standardization was directed by the Albanian Institute of Linguistics and Literature of the Academy of Sciences of Albania. Two dictionaries were published in 1954. An Albanian language dictionary and a Russian-Albanian dictionary. New orthography rules were eventually published in 1967 and 1973 Drejtshkrimi I Gjuhëzshkype. More recent dictionaries from the Albanian government are Fjalori Drejtshkrimor I Gjuhëzshkype and Dictionary of Today's Albanian Language. Prior to World War II, dictionaries consulted by developers of the standard have included Lexikon Tis Alvanicus Glossus, Fjalori I Bashkimit, and Fjalori I Gazelit. Since the fall of the communist regime, Albanian orthography has stirred heated debate among scholars, writers, and public opinion in Albania and Kosovo, with hardliners opposed to any changes in the orthography, moderates supporting varying degrees of reform, and radicals calling for a return to the Elbasan dialect. Criticism of standard Albanian has centered on the exclusion of the me plus infinitive and the Gag lexicon. Critics say that standard Albanian disenfranchises and stigmatizes Gag speakers, affecting the quality of writing and impairing effective public communication. Supporters of the Tosk standard view the 1972 Congress as a milestone achievement in Albanian history and dismiss calls for reform as efforts to divide the nation or create two languages. Moderates, who are especially prevalent in Kosovo, generally stress the need for a unified Albanian language, but believe that the me plus infinitive and geg words should be included. Proponents of the Elbasan dialect have been vocal, but have gathered little support in the public opinion. In general, those involved in the language debate come from diverse backgrounds and there is no significant correlation between one's political views, geographic origin, and position on standard Albanian. Many writers have continued to write in the Elbasan dialect, but other geg variants have found much more limited use in literature. Most publications adhere to a strict policy of not accepting submissions that are not written in Tosk. Some print media even translate direct speech, replacing the me plus infinitive with other verb forms and making other changes in grammar and word choice. Even authors who have published in the Elbasan dialect will frequently write in the Tosk standard. In recent years, a group of academics for Albania and Kosovo have proposed minor changes in the orthography. Hardline academics boycotted the initiative, while other reformers have viewed it as superficial. Media such as Rakam and Java have offered content that is almost exclusively in the Elbasan dialect. Meanwhile, author and linguist Ajim Morina has promoted a reformed version of the Tosk standard that aims at reflecting the natural development of the language among all Albanians. Morina's variant incorporates the me plus infinitive, accommodates for geg features, and provides for simpler and dialect-neutral rules. Albanian is the medium of instruction in most Albanian schools. The literacy rate in Albania for the total population, age 9 or older, is about 99%. Elementary education is compulsory, but most students continue at least until a secondary education. Students must pass graduation exams at the end of the 9th grade and at the end of the 12th grade in order to continue their education. Standard Albanian has 7 vowels and 29 consonants. Like English, Albanian has dental fricative / theta / which are rare cross-linguistically. They are written as th and dh, and similar to the consonants at the beginning of English thin and this. Geg uses long and nasal vowels, which are absent in Tosk, and the mid-central vowel e is lost at the end of the word. The stress is fixed mainly on the last syllable. Geg n changes to r by rhoticism in Tosk. Notes. Although the Indo-European schwa was preserved in Albanian, in some cases it was lost, possibly when a stressed syllable preceded it. Until the standardization of the modern Albanian alphabet, in which the schwa is spelled as e, as in the work of Jin Buzuku in the 16th century, various vowels and gliding vowels were employed, including AE by Leke Maitrenga and E by Pjetar Bogdani in the late 16th and early 17th century. The schwa in Albanian has a great degree of variability from extreme back to extreme front articulation. Within the borders of Albania, the phoneme is pronounced about the same in both the Tosk and the Geg dialect due to the influence of standard Albanian. However, in the Geg dialects spoken in the neighboring Albanian-speaking areas of Kosovo and Macedonia, the phoneme is still pronounced as back and rounded. Albanian has a canonical word order of SVO like English and many other Indo-European languages. Albanian nouns are inflected by gender and number. There are 5 declensions with 6 cases, although the vocative only occurs with a limited number of words, and the forms of the genitive and dative are identical. Some dialects also retain a locative case, which is not present in standard Albanian. The cases apply to both definite and indefinite nouns, and there are numerous cases of syncretism. The following shows the declension of mal, a masculine noun which takes I in the definite singular. The following shows the declension of the masculine noun zog, a masculine noun which takes you in the definite singular. The following table shows the declension of the feminine noun vag. The definite article is placed after the noun as in many other Balkan languages, like in Romanian, Macedonian and Bulgarian. Albanian has developed an analytical verbal structure in place of the earlier synthetic system, inherited from Proto-Indo-European. Its complex system of moods and tenses is distinctive among Balkan languages. There are two general types of conjugations. Albanian verbs, like those of other Balkan languages, have an admirative mood that is used to indicate surprise on the part of the speaker or to imply that an event is known to the speaker by report and not by direct observation. In some contexts, this mood can be translated using English apparently. For more information on verb conjugation and on inflection of other parts of speech, see Albanian morphology. Albanian word order is relatively free. To say Ajim ate all the oranges in Albanian, one may use any of the following orders, with slight pragmatic differences. However, the most common order is subject-verb-object, and negation is expressed by the particles nuk or s in front of the verb, for example. However, the verb can optionally occur in sentence initial position, especially with verbs in the non-active form. In imperative sentences, the particle mos is used for negation. The earliest known texts in Albanian. In 1967, two scholars claimed to have found a brief text in Albanian inserted into the Belli Fortis text, a book written in Latin dating to 1402-1405. A star has fallen in a place in the woods. Distinguish the star, distinguish it. Distinguish the star from the others, they are ours, they are. Do you see where the great voice has resounded? Stand beside it, that thunder. It did not fall. It did not fall for you. The one which would do it, like the ears, you should not believe, that the moon fell when, try to encompass that which spurts far, call the light when the moon falls and no longer exists. Dr. Robert Elsie, a specialist in Albanian studies, considers that the Tadarasius/Polina Romanian translation of the non-Latin lines, although it may offer some clues if the text is indeed Albanian, is fanciful and based, among other things, on a false reading of the manuscript, including the exclusion of a whole line. In 1635, Frank Bardi published in Rome his Dictionary Nerum Latinum Epiroticum, the first known Latin-Albanian dictionary. Other scholars who studied the language during the 17th century include Andrea Bogdani, author of the first Latin-Albanian grammar book, Nilo Catalanos, and others. There are some 30 ancient Greek loanwords in Albanian. Many of these reflect a dialect which voiced its aspirants, as did the Macedonian dialect. Other loanwords are Doric. These words mainly refer to commodity items and trade goods and probably came through trade with a now extinct intermediary. Some Gothic loanwords were borrowed through Late Latin, while others came from the Ostrogothic expansion into parts of Pre-Valletana around Niki and the Gulf of Kotor in Montenegro. It is assumed that Greek and Balkan Latin had exerted a great influence on Albanian. Examples of words borrowed from Latin, kytet. After the Slavs arrived in the Balkans, the Slavic languages became an additional source of loan words. The rise of the Ottoman Empire meant an influx of Turkish words, This also entailed the borrowing of Persian and Arabic words through Turkish. There is also use of some Turkish personal names such as Altan. Some loanwords from modern Greek also exist, especially in the south of Albania. A lot of the borrowed words have been resubstituted from Albanian-rooted words or modern Latinized words. Other loans. Notes. Bibliography. Albanian article research. Corded Ware, Baden, Middle Dnieper. Chariot, Yamna, Catacomb, Multi-Cordoned Ware, Poltavka, Srubna. Abashevo Culture, Andronovo, Sintashta. Globular Amphora, Corded Ware, Beaker, Unetis, Tritsinisi, Nordic Bronze Age, Turimuri, Tumulus, Urnfield, Lusitian. BMAC, Yaz, Gandhara Grave. Cher Knowles. Thracosumerian, Hallstatt, Jastorf. Kalchin. Painted Grey Ware, Northern Black Polished Ware. Indo-Aryans. Iranians, Scythians, Persians, Medes. Celts, Gauls, Celt-Iberians, Insular Celts. Tocharians. Balts, Slavs, Albanians, Medieval Europe. Medieval India. Greater Persia. Vedic, Hinduism. Persian, Zoroastrianism. Armenian. Paleo-Balkans, Greek, Roman, Celtic, Irish, Scottish, Breton, Welsh, Cornish. Some 85 Latin words have survived in Albanian but not in any Romance language. A few examples include Late Latin Celsidri Dial, Kulshitter Kukder Hydra, Hibernus Veri Winter Pasture, Sarsenrius used for packing, loading Shelkerer Forked Peg, Grapnel, Forked Hanger, Selenium Nightshade, Lit. Sun Plant Shula Sunny Place Out of the Wind, Sunbathed Area, Splinticus Spritkus Spleen, Trifurcus Turfurk Pitchfork. 151 Albanian words of Latin origin were not inherited in Romanian. A few examples include Latin amicus Albanian mic friend, inimicus armuc foe, enemy, rationem arsi, bani dikara beko j, bubulcus plowman, herdsman bulk, bujake peasant, calissus kelk drinking glass, castellum kestjul castle, centum kind hundred, Gallus Jill Rooster, Iunctra Jim Tire Limb, Joint, Medicus Mjack Doctor, Rita Mrjitnet, SPRA with Macron RE Dial Shpreya to Hope, Volence Volnet Will, Desire. Some Albanian church terminology have phonetic features which demonstrate their very early borrowing from Latin. A few examples include Albanian Beko J to Bless from Bani Dikara, Angel Angel from Angelus, Kishi Church from Ecclesia, I Christer Christian from Christianus, Kryq Cross from Crux, Altar Altar from Latin Altrium, Malko J to Curse from Mail Dikara, Meshi Mass from Missa, Merg Monk from Monacus, Peshkab Bishop from Episcopus, and Ungel Gospel from Evangelium. The contrast between flapped R and trilled RR is the same as in Spanish or Armenian. In most of the dialects, as also in Standard Albanian, the single R changes from an alveolar flap slash slash into a ret reflex flap, or even an alveolar approximant when it is at the end of a word. The palatal nasal slash slash corresponds to the Spanish N and the French and Italian GN. It is pronounced as one sound, not a nasal plus a glide. The LL sound is a velarized lateral, close to English dark L. The letter C is sometimes written CH due to technical limitations because of its use in English sound and its analogy to the other digraphs XH, SH, and ZH. Usually it is written simply C or more rarely Q with context resolving any ambiguities. The position of Q and GJ sound is not clear. Many speakers merge them into the palato-alveolar sounds C and XH. This is especially common in Northern Gag, but is increasingly the case in Tosk as well. Other speakers reduced them into slash J slash in consonant clusters, such as in the word fjall, which before standardization was written as fkl, the ng kin pronounced as slash slash in final position, otherwise as a allophone of n before k and g, before q and g j. The N is always pronounced slash slash but it's not reflected in the orthography slash. Theta, slash, and slash slash are interdental. The definite article can be in the form of noun suffixes, which vary with gender and case. For example, in singular nominative, masculine nouns add I, or those ending in G slash K slash H take U, Mal slash Molly, Liber slash Libri, Zog slash Zogu. T.I. Fleischkip. You speak Albanian, T.I. Fliskishkip. You speak Albanian, Riga. Esht imbalur. The street is closed, Riga. Kenka imbalur. The street is closed. S.V.O. Ajamai I hengri tejith portokol lit, SOV, Ajamai tejith portokol lit I hengri, OVS, tejith portokol lit I hengri Ajamai, OSV, tejith portokol lit Ajamai I hengri, VSO, I hengri Ajamai tejith portokol lit. Tony Nook flay Englished. Tony does not speak English. Tony S. Flay Englished. Tony doesn't speak English. Nook ed I do not know. Sed I don't know. Parishikoet and gender Persian interruption is anticipated. Mos Haro do not forget. Meshery of Jinbuzuka 1554-1555, a 208-page parchment written by Theodore of Shkodra discovered in the secret archives of Vatican. The work is a manuscript decorated with golden miniatures and colored initials, divided in three parts. Pages 197 deal with theology, 98-146 with philosophy, and pages 147-208 with a history of the known world from AD 153 to 1209. On the final page of the manuscript we find a note by the author: with the assistance and great love of the Blessed Lord, I finished this in the year 1210 on the 9th day of March, the formula e page zimit, which dates back to 1462 and was authored by Pal Anjali, Archbishop of Duras. Anjali was a close friend and counselor of Skander Beg. It was written in a pastoral letter for a synod at the Holy Trinity in Mat and read in Latin characters as follows: Unt pagesint premeditatit et birit et spertit senit. It was discovered and published in 1915 by Nikolai Iorga, the Fjallari I Arnold von Harfit, a short list of Albanian phrases with German glosses, dated 1496, a song, recorded in the Greek alphabet, retrieved from an old codex that was written in Greek. The document is also called Perikopija e Ungulat te Pashkev or Perikopija e Ungulat te Shen Maitut. Although the codex is dated to during the 14th century, the song, written in Albanian by an anonymous writer, seems to be a 16th century writing. The document was found by Arborish people who had emigrated to Italy in the 15th century, The first book in Albanian is the Meshuri, written by Jan Buzuka between March 20, 1554 and January 5, 1555. The book was written in the Geg dialect in the Latin script with some Slavic letters adapted for Albanian vowels. The book was discovered in 1740 by Jan Nikoli Kazazi, the Albanian Archbishop of Skopje. It contains the liturgies of the main holidays. There are also texts of prayers and rituals and catechetical texts. The grammar and the vocabulary are more archaic than those in the Geg texts from the 17th century. The 188 pages of the book comprise about 154,000 words with a total vocabulary of c. 1,500 different words. The text is archaic yet easily interpreted because it is mainly a translation of known texts, in particular portions of the Bible. The book also contains passages from the Psalms, the Book of Isaiah, the Book of Jeremiah, the letters to the Corinthians, and many illustrations. The uniformity of spelling seems to indicate an earlier tradition of writing. The only known copy of the Meshuri is held by the Apostolic Library. In 1968, the book was published with transliterations and comments by linguists. Bolt, Hive, B. Fat, Groom, Husband. OHG Diobruo, Engthai, Britches.